Number one is really knowledge and understanding of where the records are. So knowledge could be divided into understanding what is the problem that you're really trying to address, where you can get the records from, collection of those records, finding out if anybody has actually done any of this in the past, and bringing those records on board, because there is always may not really need to start everything afresh. So really, collection of those records when it comes to knowledge is very critical.
Often we start the struggle only after the processes have been completed. When we oppose a project at that stage, the struggle becomes very difficult. We do not simply follow the process, and when diversion process is complete, say that we will not allow forest clearing. Application for rights must happen well before forest clearance is necessary. What is the proposal with nodal officer? What report has been presented by the DFO? What were the recommendations by state government? Has the process of rights recognition been completed? Whether people are able to present their views and concerns to the FAC, etc., etc. This is a continuous process, and it is important to nudge every single process.
You need to actually preempt the fact there could be a road expansion in your area. There could be, the forest department could be thinking of an idea of securing this place for conservation if there is a proposed mining activity that is likely to come up. Or for that matter, they think there's too much poaching taking place, so you want to secure it. So I think communities, along with any research and local organization support, need to start preparing themselves for any intervention in that area. From the conservation point of view, from the production forestry point of view, or from the diversion and acquisition point of view.